Ask anyone looking for a job and they will tell you the market is tough. We're finding out it may be your Google resume keeping you out or getting you hired. More and more employers are using internet searches as additional background checks. Tonight, our iTeam investigation on digital dirt.
Thank you.
Thanks for stopping by.
Wednesday afternoon, some 300 job seekers drive up and drive off with packets about potential employment. Kevin Lucier is one of them. But we're curious, what's on the resume he's not handing over to businesses?
I never really thought about it, but now that you say something, you know, I'm like, huh, I wonder who could see that.
We asked Kevin to sit down with us at the Scooters next door and let us do a simple Google search for his name.
I'm interested to see what pops up, actually, like, to see if there's anything there about me.
We found that 21-year-old Kevin has a Facebook page, but our search didn't reveal any posts or photos.
I'm guessing you're not the appointed new GM at Yacht Haven.
No, I'm not.
A similar story when 33-year-old Brandon Smith sat down. We got a lot of results.
Recent paintings? You an artist?
No.
All right.
Not a drop.
Just not about him. And when Scooter's employee, Jen Corner, stepped up to the plate...
Nebraska Humane Society.
Oh, there might be something there.
Just a web post about how much money she raised for a dog walk. But Jen knows web searches can turn up much worse.
I see, you know, my friends posting things and people that I'm close to posting things, and you're like, wow, just why do you need to do that? You know, it's just not smart.
Especially if you're looking for a job. Some agencies with the state of Nebraska, for example, use internet searches as an additional resource. Mike McCrory is the director of personnel.
You take a social networking tool like this and you put in inappropriate information about yourself, perhaps inappropriate photographs of yourself, perhaps provide information of a nature that would make an employer question your suitability for employment with that organization.
McCrory's advice to job seekers, be careful.
You may put something out there that seems funny today that could compromise your opportunities either for a job or for some other benefits down the road.
Kevin left our little experiment feeling pretty confident about his Google resume.
So any of this, if an employer Googled you, anything that worries you?
No, nothing.
McCrory says some sites, like LinkedIn, for example, can actually help applicants get a job. He also has advice for employers. Do not use internet searches as a replacement for a traditional check, like with the State Patrol, the DMV, or with the prison system.
Hey, because you never know what information is true.
Exactly.
And
exactly. You got to do that additional search, maybe, but right. Do the concrete traditional ones first.
Good advice. Thanks for having me.